That's what she said. And there it is.
That was the first thing that just popped up, by the way. That's what she said.
That's what she said.
There we go.
Would it be us if it wasn't? Is that
where we're going already tonight? We're just going to start off with that's what she said?
Yeah.
Are we balanced here? Like, my shit's all cut off, my arm stuff. I don't know. Hey, we got our Whiskey and Winnie shirts on tonight.
Do you want to snuggle up closer?
I kind of want to snuggle with you a little bit. Bro. That's okay.
Yeah, bro.
I mean.
No shame. We can play footsies. Ain't no
problem. Nobody knows that we normally play footsies underneath.
Yeah, they don't know. But now they do know.
Now they do know. Yeah. Now you guys know that we play footsies. It's okay. Listen, no shame. We talked about that many times. We don't judge anybody.
We don't judge nobody.
If they want to play footsies, who cares? It doesn't matter what you want to do. As long as you're having fun doing it. We have a guest today.
Yes, we do. Man, get over here. Get in the camera. We got to...
Just smile for the camera. Yeah. Say hi. Let them know your name.
Let them know who you are.
Introduce yourself.
Yeah, there you go.
Remember me, Chris, weird guy.
Yep. Chris, weird guy. That's what he said.
Yep, pretty much.
All right, here we go. Bob, what's up, my man? Alex, he said, what's up, boys? What's up, man?
Bob Aranda from South Austin. That's your boy, isn't it? Yeah.
Bob.
So you got to give him a deuces, bro. Bob knows his beer, huh?
Yes, he does.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
Bob needs to take a little 3-hour trip and come.
Jeff
up here
said
with
quiet
us.
Crew this evening. We're gonna have to change that. We're gonna get y'all riled up and going today.
Yeah, we only let them rest for a week.
Well, 2 weeks, dude. 2 weeks. That's 2 weeks.
We did the mustache.
That was not last week.
No, last week you were gone. The week before. So
it's been 2 weeks since we've had a show though.
Yeah. All right. Something like that.
Derek said, "Holy shit, Chris finally showed up." Right, man. That's the first thing I said to him. It's like about time. He's been talking about it for the last, what the hell?
2 months.
2 months, that's right.
Yeah.
Jeff said, the little store here in Rural, right? How do you say it? No, seriously. Like, how do you pronounce Rural? Rural.
Rural?
Wait.
Rural.
Rural? Uh-huh. You can't even say it.
Rural.
Yeah. Rural. Now the comment's gone. It's something about Rural something.
Yeah?
I don't know what he said. But Alex said, in honor of the show, I'm drinking some Dragon's Milk Bourbon Barrel Aged. That a boy. I saw that, actually. When I was looking
some
it up.
Dragon's Milk?
Yeah, I was looking it up. I was looking up what kind of beer that we should, some bourbon beer that we should try out while we were at Total Wine. And I saw that. Excuse me.
Oh, there we go. You okay? Hold on.
I'm drinking beer. I'm good. All right. I'm drinking beer. So, look at this. Damien, what's up, man? He said, hey, guys, ready to drink some beer? Having a MILF. Oh, shit.
He's having a MILF. Uh-oh.
I mean.
Hey, bro.
I mean, you could.
Hey.
Sure.
Yeah.
If you want to call your wife.
We don't judge.
We don't judge. No. You know what? Maybe his wife likes that. Actually, I know what he's talking about, but it's kind of funny that he calls it a MILF.
Yeah.
Damon, you're going to have to remind us what that actually stands for. Not the real meaning, the beer meaning.
Yeah, we know the other one.
Bob said it's pronounced were roll.
Were
roll.
Bob's wrong. I'm sorry.
Rural.
Oh, he is wrong. Rural, right?
Rural. There you go.
Shit. Okay. I don't even know.
I'll just go along with it.
Derek said, you got to show us your truck. Listen, man, I will. I'm going to post pictures here soon. By the way, for those of you who have no idea what he's talking about, I just bought a new truck today. I'll just tell you guys what it is since we're on the show. It is a 2020 Raptor. So Ford Raptor, it's freaking badass, man. I put custom rims on it. It looks awesome. Huh? It's fun.
Yeah.
It's a lot of fun. It's a 10-speed. That's crazy. Did you know that?
Mm-hmm.
The truck is a freaking 10-speed. Mm-hmm. So it changes gears like every half second. It's like...
That's like the Mamagini.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. Mamagini is 10-speed, huh?
It's a 10-speed.
Does that backfire?
I have the paddle shifters on.
Do you?
Hell yeah, I do.
Sweet.
That's the Road Warrior.
Damien said MILF stands for Mother's Imperial Liquid Fantasy, a.k.a. MILF. There you go.
All right.
Oh, look, it's George Hay.
Yeah. George Hay.
George Hay. What's up, buddy? He said Ford stands for Fixed on Race Day. I tell you what, man, I love my truck. I had a Ford truck before this. It was a 2015 Lariat. And that thing, I can't tell you how many times did I take that to Colorado with the dirt bike, two dirt bikes on the back, yeah. man. And I used to, dude, when we get to Colorado, and by the way, we're going again in a couple weeks. You should see if you come off and come with us, by the way. Maybe. Yeah, we'll see.
Yeah.
But, I mean, we would go up these, like, crazy-ass dirt roads. The one place that we camp, it's literally 45 minutes of, like, crazy, bumpy dirt roads. I've never had an issue with that truck. So, you can talk shit all you want about Ford, but I like Ford. I mean, they've done a good job with their trucks, especially... God, I can't stop burping, man. It's a beer. Every time I drink beer, I just burp like crazy.
It's the bear.
They just make good quality stuff, you know? The Raptor is a great one. I'm excited to drive that thing around. But Eric said, oh, shiz. What up, boys? He said, whoa.
I could totally see him saying that, too.
I know. It's tonight craft beer night. It's not craft beer night, dude. We're talking about bourbon. Well, I guess it is craft beer, but bourbon barrel beer. We have to stick with the whiskey, right? So, and we will get into what exactly that means here in a minute. But Tim said, Ford, found on road dead back in the day. So we have a lot of Ford haters in our group. That's kind of funny. But what do you got, Chevy guys? I'm just curious.
I think we're Chevy guys.
Yeah?
Yeah, I think that's
Are you a Chevy?
Yeah,
Chevy?
I'm a Chevy guy.
You're a Chevy guy?
Yeah, I'm a Chevy.
Chevy guy. Yeah. I'm a Chevy guy.
I'm chubby and Chevy, but yeah.
All right. Everybody's saying found on road dead. I don't know. Like, y'all are knocking Ford. I would gladly race anybody in my Raptor. I almost got the Shelby Raptor.
Yeah.
Which is 750 horsepower.
Yeah.
And it's like ridiculous, man. Like, ridiculous. Eric said, is this the Redneck Bush episode? No. Bush, some Bush Light.
No, we should have had Natty Lights.
You know what we'll do? We'll do an episode. Yeah, for sure. We'll do a Natty Light episode. But actually, we'll do a shitty beer episode.
All right.
And
I kind of like Natty Light, bro. I'm not going to lie. When I'm out four-wheeling...
Okay, that's different, though. When you're four-wheeling, I mean, it's like 2.5% alcohol. It's got nothing in it. And it tastes like water. It probably is half water, to be honest.
But you know what? I'll drink Natty Light before I drink Coors Light.
You're probably staying hydrated.
Yeah, that's
while you drink the beer. Because it's mostly water.
Mm-hmm.
I used to drink a lot of Natty Light in college. In college, because you can buy like a 24 pack for $8 or something like that.
No, bro, it ain't even 24s. It's like 30 packs, like the cubes they call it.
Dude, we used to just buy shit ton of Natty Light just so we could play beer pong. And that's what we'll do. We'll have a beer pong episode.
All right.
So we'll set up beer pong.
All right, man, you're invited to the beer.
We'll have a party. Oh, hey, we're gonna have a massive party. Probably against social distancing guidelines here in a couple weeks. Mama and Papa Spencer coming to town. Did you know that?
Yes, I did.
You did know that?
Bro.
Hey, but you didn't know that. Did you know my sister's coming
in
too?
Yes, bro.
She's coming to town.
And I know that we need to have some Bud Light for your brother-in-law.
Yeah, he loves his Bud Light, dude.
Dude, you're like, wait. Yeah.
All right. Melinda must have been talking to you. I don't know. I have been gone for a while. But Tim said he likes Ford, just giving a hard time. It's Bush Latte now.
Okay, bro.
What?
He just brought up a good point.
What's that?
On the day that we're doing the beer pong, I'm going to show up with the 40.
Kawama.
I
don't even know what that is.
A 40? You never had a big 40-ounce beer, bro? Like the Mickey's and all Old English and all that crap? I won't drink that stuff. But I'll have maybe a Corona or a Modelo. Big old...
Okay, like a big one. So what I like to do is, you know those big Bubba jugs?
Uh-huh.
They're massive ones. They're like that thick.
That's what she said.
There you go. Uh-huh. So you know, and they're like that tall too. So, well, maybe not that tall. But I used to fill them up, and it probably takes 4 or 5 beers to fill those things up. And I just walk around to one of those Bubba jugs with beer. I used to do that fishing, actually.
Yeah?
Yeah, when we used to go to Myrtle Beach, every single year for vacation. And I would just take a Bubba jug and just fill it up with Corona Light or Corona with some limes, and it just, and dude, I'd be sitting there just getting hammered off of beer while I'm fishing.
You just brought me some memories. When we used to go mess around, we would go either dirt bike riding or on the sand rails or whatever. Hey, Combs, you remember the big jugs of Clamato Bud Light? We would do like a, kind of like a Michelada type of deal in these big old cups, bro, and just, nice. Yeah.
I remember one time, man, when I was really drunk, just like really drunk, drinking a bunch of beer, and I caught a stingray. Have you ever caught a stingray before? It they are hard to reel in.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. It's like a dead weight. I don't know if it's like a defense mode, but they just go, and they just do not move. Like really? They sit on the bottom and they just do not move. So I was sitting there and my pole. I thought I was stuck because my pole was like this, just like. And I'm like, okay, I'm not quite sure what's going on. And finally, I got it to move. Probably after a couple minutes, mm-hmm. And then I reeled this thing in. It's just a big old stingray.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's pretty dope.
Yeah. Yeah. Speaking of fishing, we gotta go fishing again.
We do.
You gotta buy new worms because the old ones kind of went bad.
Yeah, we found out the hard way. Hey, don't leave your fishing worms in the refrigerator and forget about them for 2 weeks.
Yeah. Was I traveling last week?
Huh?
Yeah, I was gone last week, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's like two, it is 2 weeks old. Oh my God. No wonder.
I do remember that, Combs. Oh my God. Okay, you know that
what?
Tequila and squirt drink that I do, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so back in the days, before the Don Julio and all that, Cazadores used to be really good and it wouldn't mess you up. We would literally do, like you did that big Bubba.
Yeah, yeah.
We would do that, but it would be literally tequila and squirt with the lime and all that in these big old jugs. I think we'd pour half a bottle into each one of those.
No shit.
Yeah, bro.
Damn.
Those were some bachelor parties.
Why does that sound so good right now?
It is refreshing, too.
It does. It sounds hell really yeah. good.
You know what? We're going to have one of the episodes where we do those.
We'll have a squirt episode?
Yeah.
Some
tequila and squirt. Yeah. People right. call them palomas. I call them tequirts.
Yeah. Damien said when you said you were drunk and caught a stingray, I thought you meant with your...
Oh, yeah.
With your hands.
Hey, buddy.
That'd be cool, though. That'd be cool to catch a stingray with your hands. They actually have a place down in Cayman Islands, and these guys know one of our favorite places to visit is Grand Cayman, and they have a place called Stingray City. So you actually get to swim with the stingrays, and you can pick them up with your hands and stuff. So that reminds me of that, Damien, because when I do that, I'm normally drunk. I mean, on vacation, we're normally drunk.
We're normally drunk.
Actually, there's probably not a sober moment. There's definitely more drunk moments than there are sober moments
I would
when we
say
go on
that.
Vacation
yeah.
together. Because we start drinking at, what, like 9 a.m.?
As soon as we put something in our mouth.
I don't. You said it. I did not say it.
And you totally didn't. You didn't even mention it.
I didn't need to. I looked at you. They saw. I looked at you.
Yeah, that was pretty good.
No, they don't.
Yeah,
so
that was nice.
I mean, I work out in the morning, and then I mean, literally, as soon as the workouts are done, I used to come to your room, right, and we just start drinking.
Start drinking.
Right. And we have a damn good time. That's
the important thing. We have a hell of a time.
It's the only thing. Like, it's the only thing that matters is, are you having a good time on vacation? Because that's what vacation is for.
Yep.
So
kiddos have a blast.
Hey,
wives have a blast.
That's a good question to ask these guys.
What?
What is your favorite beach drink?
Ooh. Ooh.
Mojito.
Oh, your mojito.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. It's refreshing, man.
It is.
Okay.
I'll give you that. What about you? What is your favorite beach drink? Because people are all over the place with this. I'm kind of curious. What is you guys' favorite beach
drink? Well, it also depends,
drink?
Bro.
Huh.
For me, it does. So, okay, we just went to the beach, and we could totally say if we could walk into Margaritaville and take our little bubbas to fill them up with 5 o'clock somewheres and go to the beach, that's our favorite beach drink.
We'd also be fucked up in 2 hours.
Yeah.
I mean... Yeah, so you think that would be your okay?
But that's not normally what we do.
All day sipper.
You and I do the same thing that we do when we're hanging out. When we're mixing, either we're mixing rum with stevia and sparkling water, and when we change it up, we just change the rum and put whiskey. So
I mean, it's a mixed drink for me.
Yeah,
it's got to be a mixed drink. I like. I'm obviously a whiskey guy. Good Lord,
no, bro, are you serious?
I like Evan Williams. I'm about to sneeze. I like Evan Williams and Zevia, which these guys know.
Yeah. Salud.
Bless you.
Corona.
Oh, Rob said Mai Tais.
Margaritas.
Rob,
look at that.
Have you had a Mai Tai from Tommy Bahama Cafe? Now that's a Mai Tai, right, bro?
Dude, that's a legit Mai Tai.
Legit.
Yeah. Should we move to the first one while we're talking?
We can.
Yeah, yeah. Go ahead. You want to grab?
Go, bro.
In the freezer, grab. Don't get the Kentucky Bourbon one. That's my favorite. Get the other one that we had. There's two of them. Are you ready to get messed up? Because these are 11% alcohol, 12% alcohol.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Looks like we're gonna get stouts.
Was
bourbon.
That? Yeah, there was the stout.
Which one?
They have the Boulevard Stout ones.
Right.
I didn't get those ones. Okay. This is the ones that was rated when I Googled it. This was the one that was rated higher than the stouts.
Okay.
Yeah. You get three of them, dude.
Yeah.
You're drinking one too.
Yeah.
So I saw somebody said Mai Tai. Somebody Bob said I just like rum. Yeah. Listen, I'm a rum guy too, and you know that. I don't discriminate between rum and whiskey, especially when I'm on vacation. We're sitting there on the beach. It's just something cold and just a slow sipper. Although, I don't know.
It's
not a slow sipper because we chug it and I don't know. But there's some days too where I just want to sit with an ice cold beer on the beach.
There he is. There you go, sir.
Thank you. All right, so there's a few things that we need to talk about first.
Yes.
Number one.
Please join us with something
drinking.
To drink.
Yep.
Okay, whatever you prefer. Today we're doing beer. But please be of legal age. Please. Okay?
Yeah.
We want to encourage you to drink if you are of legal age.
Yeah, we don't want 9-year-olds joining us and drinking.
Yeah. No, we definitely don't want. But you guys need to tell us where you're from.
Yep.
And what you're drinking.
What
and
you're
share,
drinking.
Man. Share, share, share.
Yeah, yeah. Please share this episode. We always have a good time, obviously. And we are building this page. And we are building our brand. And it's working. We got a big following.
Yeah.
And but the only way for us to grow is for you to tag your whiskey-loving buddies or beer, whatever. You know, beer-loving buddies. We've also had... I don't even care. If you like liquor, just tag your buddies.
Yes. That's what we're about.
We're just about liquor.
Yes.
Mostly whiskey.
Yeah, mostly whiskey, but
yeah,
I love my tequila.
Yeah, tag your buddies, share the episode. We would really appreciate it. It means a lot to us.
Yep.
That is the number one thing.
Okay.
Yep. Number two, I have to talk about our fundraiser because we've been doing just incredible with that. And last week, you guys know that we met, well, not 2 weeks ago.
2 weeks ago.
We started the Mustaches for Menners. The Rat Packs are the Mustaches for Menners. And what we're trying to do is we're trying to raise, now it's $100,000 by the end of August for the Big Brothers Big Sisters organization. And so far, I think we're around $40,000+. And for those of you who don't know anything about Big Brothers Big Sisters, it's an incredible organization where volunteers join and they mentor children who just are in need of a positive influence in their life. So parents or grandparents, whoever has responsibility of these kids, they enroll them in this program, and then volunteers come in, and then for once a month, these volunteers go and they just spend time with these kids and teach them life lessons. I've been involved for a lot of years, guys, both as a mentor and financially, and it's one of the best organizations that you can find because of the impact that it's having on people. So if you guys could do it, and maybe if we can get somebody, I need to share the link somewhere. If one of you guys has a link to the Mustaches and Mentors, you can drop it in the comment for donation. All we're asking for is $5. And
$5.
The way, listen, everybody on this show, everybody who's tuning into the show, everybody who is a part of the Whiskey and Winning Club, by the way, you have to be a part of the Whiskey and Winning Club to enroll in this raffle. There is a raffle. So if you're not part of the Whiskey and Winning Club yet, just search for it and request to join, and we will add you.
Yep.
But once you do, and if you donate anything, and by the way, 100% of the proceeds are going directly to Big Brothers Big Sisters of America. We've already set it up so the GoFundMe goes directly to them, not to any of us. But once you do that and you're part of the Whiskey and Winning Club, We will put you in a raffle for a bottle of J.D. Sinatra, okay? And you guys, for those of you who have followed us for quite some time, you know that J.D. Sinatra is one of our favorite whiskeys. It's been in our top five both times now. right? It's an incredible bottle. We are going to send it to you. It doesn't matter how much you donate. If you donate anything, we are going to put you in the raffle. Anything that you guys can do is appreciated. Again, we are trying to reach $100,000 by the end of August, and we are well on our way to reach that point. You can see my mustache is getting really freaking thick, man. Yeah, and so is yours.
Yeah, I'm starting to look like a cholo.
Look like a cholo. But I mean,
like a cholo.
Dude, my mustache. And here's the thing is, if I let this thing continue to grow, my mustache gets so big and thick. Like, it really does. I'm actually thinking about doing it.
You know,
That is what he said. Yeah.
He said.
But as you can see, all of us Rat Pack members, we're starting to let our beards come out too, which is because I look like a creeper, man. We were traveling. Not only did I look like a creeper, you should have seen Mick. This guy got so many looks. Waitresses came up and they laughed at us. It was like, it was so funny. But it is an incredible cause, guys, and we are trying to help a lot of kids. So anything that you guys can do, we really appreciate. Okay, so now on to the show. This is episode number 24 of the Whiskey Winning Show, and today is all about bourbon barreled beer.
Yep.
And we're only going to do two of them because, well, these things are not... They're not low on alcohol, okay? I mean, these are incredibly strong. There's two of them that we're talking about tonight, and the first one is
12.2.
Dude, 12.2%. Jeez.
All right, so
it's called Boulevard Bourbon Barrel Quad Barrel Aged Ale. All right, and you just did this, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
Okay, well, they can see it again. Thank you guys so much for posting the link. Chris,
cheers, man.
I saw that you just posted it.
And I just donated too.
Oh, thank you very much, man. Really appreciate it. And it's hard when you're single to rock a mustache. Dude, look at Mikey, dude. Look at Mikey. Poor Mikey. But he's grown his beard out now, so he's good. Yeah. Whoo. Smells damn good.
It smells really good.
I love, dude, I'm such a beer fan. And here's the problem. When it gets to the fall months, starting now, I love October beer, dude.
Yes.
Like I know that the whole pumpkin beer is like pumpkin spice women. I don't know. I don't care.
I don't either.
I don't care because I'm a huge fan of harvest or pumpkin beers. I think
especially
they're incredible.
Especially the Samuel Adams. Adams does a great job with all their October beers.
They do. So Bob said Boulevard Quad. I don't know what he's talking about. But, I don't know. But
Boulevard.
It's refreshing.
Chris said bourbon beer. Oh, yes, bourbon beer. Oh, we never explained what this meant. Okay. So what happens, guys? And people are like, what are you talking about? What do you mean bourbon beer? So there's companies out there that will say they're a beer company, right? Boulevard Beer Company, whatever. So what they will do is after, say, like Jack Daniels or Woodford Reserve, after they use their whiskey barrels, right? So after they empty their whiskey barrels, these companies will come through and they will purchase those used whiskey barrels from these other the bourbon companies. And then, yes, the distilleries. And then they will put the beer and age the beer in the whiskey barrel. So what happens is the bourbon and the whiskey get soaked up into the beer, which is why this is such high alcohol content.
Yep.
Now, they are so good.
This is really
so
good.
I haven't tried it yet. I haven't tried it. No.
Well, try it, sir.
Well, I'm talking.
Well, come on.
All right.
Ain't that freaking great?
Oh,
dude, this thing is really good, right?
Wow.
Okay, have you ever seen when they melt sugar, that smell?
Molasses. Is that what you're
almost like molasses, but not so much. Or like cotton candy.
Is so good.
Cotton candy when you're. That's what I get. I get like a sugary smell.
Guys, this one is incredible. So again, and there's people asking, Boulevard Bourbon Barrel Quad Barrel Aged.
Yep.
Okay. So I'll hold it up here.
That's what she said. I'll hold it up here. Burro, what's up?
Xavier, what's up, man? He said he needs these like now. Dude, these are so good, man. These are
they
so
are
good.
Freaking good. What's up?
Bob has a good point, actually.
What did Bob say?
First snobby Bobby comment, pour them into a glass, even if it's a rocks glass. Really?
Trust me.
Yeah?
Especially on the bourbon barrels, you won't regret it.
Really?
Mm-hmm. All right.
Okay.
Let's go see.
Do we have ice in there?
I don't think we need ice. Well, we're just going to pour it in there. We're going to be snobs. Whatever.
All right. I guess. I mean, if I'm drinking beer, though, normally it's just straight out of the bottle.
You know what? We can't.
We're going to...
We didn't wash them.
Oh, we don't have any cups?
No.
Sorry, Bob. We don't have any cups, buddy. It's still good. Yeah. Sort of opens them up a little bit. I get it. Like it's just like whiskey. I get it does, but
yeah.
It still tastes damn good.
Is really good.
Yeah. I'm gonna be burping all night. Oh, sorry guys.
There you go.
There
bro.
We go. All
right.
People join it. We're gonna have women join it and be like, oh, that's disgusting.
Yeah.
Like these guys are pigs. Opens them up. That's what he said, by the way.
Yeah. After he's done, he says he opens them up.
Opens them up.
Well, whatever.
Yeah. He said no worries, just for next time. Alex said yes, definitely better in a glass. All right, let me see. Let me see if I can find something. I have beer glasses.
Alex said the same thing.
All right.
We should have thought ahead. We might have chilled some glasses, you know. But it's all right.
I know. Well,
it is what it is.
With me buying the freaking truck, I was so far behind. Like I don't have beer glasses in here.
We don't.
I don't have any beer glasses. I have them
all. Yeah, I have a beer glass right here. Look.
There you go. I have a beer glass.
B-double-E-double-R-U-N.
You know, this beer glass was $3.99.
$3.99?
Yeah, I just had to pay for the liquid inside of it.
Oh.
What's up, bro?
Wait. Charger is about to fall off. Oh.
Whoa. You all right?
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, no!
No!
What?
Dude, why would that do that?
Oh, shit.
What happened? I don't know.
Did we lose them?
Damn. Why would that do that? Oh, hey, we're back.
It's
okay.
In pit mode.
Oh, it's on the bottom. See it?
What is it?
You're over there leaning down. There you go. Now you're back up.
Oh, hey. We back? Sorry, guys.
Are we back, guys?
Oh, I don't know. Hey, George Hay said go Lakers.
Yes, sir. We better win tonight, man. If not... Yeah.
I'm not going to lie, I've not been watching basketball.
I have not either.
You know my reasons.
We don't want to go there.
Not going to go there.
No, we're not.
But I am watching baseball, and dude, the Indians. Los Indios!
Yes, sir.
Los Indios are rocking it, man.
You know who's really rocking it?
Los Dodgers!
Yes, sir!
The Los Dodgers!
Los Dodgers!
Los Dodgers!
Yes, sir!
Am I saying it right? Los Dodgers!
Mm-hmm.
You got yellow too, right? All right.
Yeah.
Dude, both of them, both teams are doing well. Hey, Bieber, did you see that stat?
Yeah.
Bieber has...
Did you also see what happened with your two all-star pitchers?
Yeah, I sort of saw it because I was on vacation. Okay.
So they decided that when they went to go play Detroit, that they were going to go party with the buddies, and then they lied to the team. And then they said they didn't, and then they found out they did, and they, you know, all the other
so
players.
So they're partying? I don't...
Yeah, they went out, and you know, they're not supposed to be going out because everybody's in quarantine. Yeah. Yeah, but, you know.
I mean, I don't know.
Lindor, all those guys were like saying they need to go. If they jeopardize everybody, and they didn't care, and then they lied to us. Oh, yeah.
Hold on a minute. Oh.
No, we're not going to get political. I'm just telling you what happened.
Oh, that's not political.
It is.
No, it's not political.
It's going to go there.
These are the same guys that are wearing a mask on the ball
field.
They're wearing a mask. It's shortstop. Lindor's wearing a mask in shortstop. You're going to catch the virus from a freaking sand bug just running around? I'm just curious.
Bro,
man.
I don't catch the bug even if I'm out there with a mask. Yeah.
I'm just saying, man.
I know, bro. It's all crazy.
Like that, to kick two guys off the team for that is a little much in my opinion.
It's
a little much in my opinion. Whatever.
Yeah.
Okay. Should they have gone out? No, they shouldn't have gone out.
Well, and if they did, they should have just fessed up.
Owned up to it.
Yeah. Like, hey, guys, you know what? We screwed up.
Apologize for it, and then move on.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. But
Xavier said, "My team, the Indians, Los Indios."
Los Indios, bro.
They're doing well, man. And they're actually...
I hope I get to see you, bro.
Hmm?
I want to see you in the World Series because you know my Dodgers.
I want to go.
Hold on, let me say, my Dodgers are going to be there.
The Indians might. They have it. They have the talent to do it. I don't know if they. I mean, if they kick these two pitchers off the team, then we're screwed. There's no doubt about that. But
you know, one of them will probably end up in Los Dodgers.
It'd be dumb for them to kick the guys off the team. Man. It would. Seriously.
No, it would be.
I mean, two of our top pitchers.
It's like they need to get over it.
It's time to get over it.
They need to stop being bajiji.
It's time to stop being a little bajiji and time to, you know, the guys, what they need to do is they need to get together as a club, and these two need to address the club and say, hey, listen, guys, we get it. Like, even if their beliefs are different, we get it. We understand where you're coming from. We messed up. Please forgive us, and let's move forward with this. Not drag it on, for God's sake. You know what I mean? I don't know, man. But anyways, talking about Bieber. So, Shane Bieber, and he is tied for the record. Well, no, number three for the record of most strikeouts in the first three games ever.
Yeah.
Ooh, yeah. First three games, or first four games pitched. He has 56 strikeouts. You know who he's with? He's with Pedro Martinez.
Okay.
Nolan Ryan.
Okay.
And Randy Johnson.
Ooh, the big unit. That's good.
That's a hell of a freaking.
That when you're up in those rankings, yep.
He's gonna win Cy.
Hey, my Combs wants to know what's our
whiskey drinking song.
Whiskey drinking,
dude.
Song.
That's. Go ahead.
Chris Stapleton, Tennessee whiskey.
I mean, that is the
staple.
But it's kind of funny. I was gonna say though, like, well, that's funny. Stapleton staple.
Yeah,
oh, is the staple whiskey song.
It is.
I mean, okay.
And you know what? Damn Corona. Listen, we were gonna be sitting in the freaking front listening to that damn song.
Pisses me off, man.
Completely faded. Because we were going to pregame.
We were going to pregame.
Oh, yeah.
For this concert. So, for his birthday, right?
Yeah, it was for my birthday.
I surprised him and got him, like, it was like front row tickets to Chris Stapleton where him and I were going to go. We were going to pregame in the freaking parking lot and just have a damn good time. And then this whole Corona thing ruined the whole thing.
It went wah, wah.
It did. It just ruined the whole thing. And just, you know.
We were going to be able to be the first people. You know, for an event at the Globe, what is it, Globe Life Field?
The new Globe Life Field of the Texas Rangers.
With Justin Timberlake version? No, but that is a good version.
George,
I like the OG one.
George Hay.
Yeah.
Oh.
What?
He's talking about Justin Timberlake.
Bro, that was a nice little setup that they did. I'm not going to knock it. When they played at the Country Music Awards, I was like, damn, that sounded pretty dope. But no, the original version. And then after that, but before we get to that Tennessee whiskey, my staple song, what got me into freaking country music is Jake Owen, Down to the Honky Tonk.
That's true. So listen.
That is my song.
You guys have to understand this. Whenever Carlos is in a shitty mood, or I'm in a shitty mood, and it does happen every once in a while.
Yep.
Okay?
Believe it or not, we do.
We do get in shitty moods.
Yeah.
If all we have to do is either call each other up, or we go over to each other's houses, and we'll just blast one of these songs, and instantly,
we snap out of it.
It's done. It is. I don't know why. Like, it every single time it's like that. Because
we could have poo-poo faces, and
well, we do.
Yeah.
You know, and then the poo-poo faces just go away. It's just, I don't know. I don't know what it is. I think the songs remind us of sitting outside on a patio in the summer, not worrying about a damn thing, even
just
with
drinking.
All this bullshit going on. You know what I mean? I mean, we listen to these songs and it just snaps us
we're just happy out of our mood.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Oh, George Hay. Dude, I'm a big, okay. He's going to my area now.
Oh yeah.
Stained, it's been a while. Yes, sir.
Oh.
Yes, sir. So I am one of the biggest Stained fans that there is. I freaking love that band. I'm so bummed that they are not together anymore. But that is one of my favorite songs. You are right. If I hear that song, it's another one where it just instantly snaps me out. I'm just like, yeah. I actually listened. It was funny because I put Stained Station on Amazon the other day.
Uh-huh.
I think when I was driving home from somewhere, wherever I'm at. I drive everywhere. You know that. Golly.
Hey, buddy.
That's a good question. Let's ask.
Gomes is planning a trip out here. So we need to have him.
Gomes!
George.
George?
George. George is going to come out here. Well, that's what he said.
Yeah.
So now, look, well, in front like of everybody.
Chris. It's like Chris, right?
He finally made it.
Well, he's here.
Yeah, he's here.
So we can't dog on him anymore.
Yeah, we can't dog on him.
So, okay, that brings up a good point. You guys, what is your favorite? What is that song of yours that just instantly snaps you out of a bad mood? Instantly. We are curious.
So put it up there. What is it? Okay, Xavier said Rick McMorris, Whiskey Top.
Dude, Xavier, this guy's a rock star in the beach body business, by the way.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I had a call with him probably about a month ago, and he's just one of those guys that get it, man.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, just want to work their ass off to build a business, and he listens, too, because I've been watching his stuff. He doesn't know this, because he's not on my team, right? But we had a call. I had a call with him. He asked if we could set up a call, and I'm like, yeah, sure. So we set up a call. And I've been watching his page and stuff, and his content is, dude, your content's awesome, man. I love your stuff. Seriously, you're doing a great job. So Teresa said, Love Stained. Chris said, Whiskey and Smoke by the Cadillac 3. What is that?
I don't know.
All right, hold on. I don't know the song.
Me neither.
Whiskey and Smoke.
Oh, Bob went with Earth, Wind, right. and Fire. Wow. September. Wow, that's a classic one there.
Whiskey and Smoke?
Yeah.
Cadillac 3. Yeah, I got it. I brought it up. I've never heard this song. All right. We're going to play it for you guys.
Oh, Facebook. Snap. Combs just said Carrie Underwood before he cheats.
Damn! That's where we're going. That's where we're going. Boom. All right.
Oh, man.
Cadillac 3, Whiskey and Smoke. Dude, I've got a topic for the rest of the episode, and it's just... What is this shit?
Oh!
Oh. Talking about Mary Jane.
Mary Jane.
A little rockish, countryish. I've never heard of them. You?
I haven't either.
I'm with you, Derek. Baby Shark, man.
We're going to have to listen to that. I'm a big rock guy.
Yeah.
You know that. I'm a big country guy, too. That'd be interesting. So, Derek said Baby Shark.
You know what's so funny? Ooh. I bet you all my boys that are watching, hearing me talking about country music, are like, what the hell? Yeah. I'm a brown necker now.
All right. So while everybody is posting their happy songs. Oh, Zach Brown Band, Chicken Fried, or Toes in the Sand. Okay, so Damien's right.
Toes in the Sand.
I gotta agree with that. Toes in the Sand is a hell of a good song. Deftones.
Yeah, it is. Wow, Sex and Candy.
Deftones is good.
Yeah.
Sex and Candy by Marcy. Dude, okay, so you want to hear a Sex and Candy song or story? So...
That kind of sounds funky, bro. Sex and candy.
You've never heard of Marcy Playground?
Maybe I have. I just don't know the name.
I love sex and candy, yeah. Who's that lounging in my chair?
Okay, okay. You're a better singer than me, obviously.
Yeah,
so.
It's you. All right.
No, but, I mean...
No, bro. No.
Never heard of that?
Hey, it's okay. I could play you some fucking Paisa stuff that you never heard.
That's
fine. You
know? Hey, yeah, that's all right. That's fine. So back in the day when I was in college, Marcy Playground actually came and did a concert there at my college, like a very, very small college, because it was at that point to where they were totally falling off. You know what I mean? Like they were totally gone.
Rihanna.
What?
Rihanna Trujillo. Baby Got Back. Yeah, that's a.
Well, you can't. Yeah, you can't go wrong with that song.
Hell no,
Baby Got Back.
Back. Doom, 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 doom. Yeah.
Chris said Cadillac 3 is an amazing southern rock country band. Dude, I've got to.
Yeah.
Because I mean, that's like our thing, right?
Yeah,
country
like
and rock.
Rock and country.
Yeah.
Damn.
Teresa said Jimmy Buffett.
Jimmy Buffett. Yep.
Can't go wrong with Jimmy Buffett.
Hell no. Jimmy Buffett and Alan Jackson together.
Pour me something tall and strong. Make it a hurricane before I go insane. That's like our Margaritaville music,
yes,
right there.
Yes, it is.
So when we go to Margaritaville, and by the way, in Destin, when we went to Destin,
yep,
we have a Margaritaville there, and the new investment property that we purchased, second home, whatever, also has a Margaritaville next to it. But this is where we go. This is our jam. This is,
yeah,
our place where we go if we want to get tipsy.
Faded. No. We want to get faded. It's not even tipsy. It's faded, quick, boom, 5 o'clock somewhere. If you guys are ever at a beach,
yeah,
there's a Margaritaville. Go in there, order the 5 o'clock somewhere, and it's gonna knock you on your asses real quick.
Derek said Red Solo Cup.
Oh,
by Toby Keith.
I like that.
I gotta agree. Okay, so Derek, I don't know if you know the story behind that. Toby Keith had no intentions of making this a hit. Okay, he and I actually watched a whole documentary or whatever it was. I don't know, one night, but he was drunk with his friends and just started making up this shit, making up words to a song.
Feel this thing.
Me too.
Yeah.
It's 12%. He started making up words to a song, and it was that song. It was Red Solo Cup. So they're like, oh man, that's actually good, dude. You should probably put it into a song. He's like, okay, let's put it in a song. And it became a huge hit for him. I agree with you. I love that song. Red Solo Cup. I fill you up. Let's have a party. Proceed to party.
You should play it. That's an uppity song.
I can't because Facebook is really funny about copyright issues.
Oh, that is.
So if, yeah, I start playing music on here, they're going to kick us off this damn thing.
Yeah.
Damien said, can't wait to hit Margaritaville, Panama City Beach with you. Hell yeah. So as soon as it opens, man, listen. Golly. I'm going to... Thank you. I really need to be burped tonight.
All right.
As soon as our property, by the way, Damien, he has a property in the same building that we do. We're all going to meet up. You're going to come with us.
Yep.
And we are all going to get together, and we're just going to party for like 4 days straight, and we're going to go to Margaritaville.
And have a 5 o'clock somewhere, and then we're going to go live.
3 5 o'clock somewhere, and we're going to go live.
Well, maybe it won't be 3, maybe like 6, but yeah.
Woo! 6?
You and I did it.
Dude, we have 3. Each. 3 each.
No, I'm talking 6 because it was 2 each.
Now you're really confusing me.
Are you sure?
3
okay, no.
each.
Okay, well, first, I was saying, you said 1. I said we could have 6, so that'd be 2, 4, and Damien makes 6.
2 each is that's an okay buzz.
That's like chilling. So we're going to do 2.
3 each.
And then we're going to leave with 1.
No. Yes.
See? So we'll do 2 there.
Okay. So we'll do 3 each.
3 each.
9 total. 5 o'clock somewhere.
5 o'clock somewhere.
We're going to be stumbling our way back home is what's going to happen.
It's going to look freaking hilarious.
It's going to be hilarious. We should do a call. We should do a video.
We should do a video.
Do a live video.
We're going
to
do a live video when we're there. Yeah.
While we're doing that.
Yeah.
This is good stuff, man.
It is.
I tell you what, you cannot chug it, though.
No.
This is not
you can't chug
this. Is not a beer that you could chug.
Are you crazy?
You guys, seriously, this is so good, though.
Here we go again. If you have not bought this, go get yourself a 4-pack. Because it's not a 6-pack. It's a 4-pack.
It is a 4-pack. Total Wine has it.
Yeah.
Total Wine. This is where... And by the way, have you ever looked... There you go.
Yeah.
Have you ever looked at the beer selection from Total Wine?
Dude, they got
a... Oh, my God, dude. It's
beer,
like...
Beer and wine is like their thing. They throw the damn whiskey and the tequila for us just to shut us up.
They got a lot of whiskey,
they do,
though.
They do, bro, but, you know, whatever.
I don't know. They got a lot of beer. Is that a hard beer to find?
No,
I don't think so.
It's all around, everywhere.
It is. It's a... Well... It depends on where you go. I mean,
you got to go to a place that
has a lot of selection.
Yes.
I mean, so like a Total Wine or a
Specs
would probably have it.
Yeah.
But Chris, I don't know where Chris is from. See, he might be from a smaller town.
Chris Jones, where are you from?
He mentions it all the time. I just don't remember.
I think this is a Missouri beer.
Missouri?
I think so.
I don't remember.
Boulevard. Papa Spence is in the house.
Papa Spence.
Dude, you should see Dad. He's got a full beard going on, man.
Does he?
Yeah, he looks like a pimp.
Like that?
Yeah, he does. Yeah. He looks like a pimp.
Well, I get to see him pretty soon.
I know, you do in a couple weeks. Dad, don't shave your beard. Keep your beard. I'm not shaving mine at all. All right, this thing's just keeping going.
And I'm going to look like a full-on diehard cholo by the time you get here.
He's from New York.
Albany, New York.
Yeah, so I mean, I don't. They don't have Total Wine up there. That's the thing. No, they don't have a Specs either. I don't know what their liquor stores are.
I'm pretty sure you could get this online though.
I'm sure you can find it somewhere. Yeah. It's really freaking good. But hey, Chris.
Try it.
By the way, Chris, I will say our next beer, which we will reveal in a minute.
Yeah.
You can find up there, and I know that for a fact because it's all over Ohio. Okay. Dad says it stays. His beard stays.
The whole thing, huh? Yeah. All right.
All right. So, are you ready to move in a weird direction?
Whoa.
No, this is a weird direction. Whoa. Yeah, we're going there. You sound like freaking Donald Trump right now. Wow.
Hold on. Let me fix my hairpiece.
You need to paint yourself orange at the same time.
Yeah, I'm a little. Few shades away from that.
Yeah, you got it. Yeah, a little bit.
Just a little bit.
Do you ever listen to... what's his freaking name?
Finish this.
Dude, I'm freaking got a really good buzz going on, and I cannot remember. Who's the guy that has the podcast who just signed...
How you doing?
What's the guy's name?
Joe Rogan.
Okay, do you ever listen to Joe Rogan podcast? Yes. Right? So... Yeah. On the way to wherever we went, to Colorado last time, and then on the way back, we listened to the Joe Rogan podcast. We listened to a bunch of them. One of them, he had Elon Musk on. Have you ever listened to that one?
No, I have not. Yeah?
Dude, this is the second time that he's been on that show. And by the way, Elon Musk, for those of you who don't know, he's the founder of Tesla. And probably one of the smartest men in the entire world. I mean, seriously, an absolute genius. But they got into a conversation. I really want to get your thoughts and opinion on this. And this is not political, okay? We're not going in any political direction.
We don't do that. Yeah.
They went in this direction, and all of us in the car on the way over or on the way home, we're all listening to this, and all of us were just silent with our minds just kind of blown. But according to Elon Musk, Joe Rogan asked him, he said, okay, when do we develop AI to the point to where it interacts or it integrates with humans?
Ooh.
Do you know? I'm going to let you take a guess of what Elon's response was, because he's working on it currently right now.
I'm sure he'd be all for it. Guarantee you he's all for it.
Take a guess how long he thinks it's going to... Until we start doing stuff.
I don't think it's that far.
What's your guess, Chris?
In terms of how long?
Yeah.
Maybe the next 3 to 5 years?
I was going to say 5 to 10.
1 year. He's currently working on something to where, and this is just for the disabled.
Okay.
So neurological disorder where they're disabled from the limbs, right? So like a quadriplegic or, whatever. So it's a neurological thing. He is in development and says he will have it ready in the next year of a piece of thing. Okay, so what they will do, this is insane. Like this is gonna blow your mind in the direction that this is gonna go. You're gonna be like, what in the world, right? So it's a little chip, and what they do is they go in and they take a part of your skull out.
Yeah,
okay, and then they install this in your head with little neuron, little things that hang down, little whatever that connect to the specific neurons or whatever. And these people will be able to have fully function everything again. He's saying that they will have fully functioning arms, legs. If somebody is blind, they will be able to see. If somebody cannot hear, they will be able to hear in the next year. They are developing it right now.
But it's also kind of dangerous at the same time.
It is dangerous.
Okay.
It's super exactly, dangerous.
Right? This is a gamble.
It is a gamble.
Because, because you don't stop there.
No,
never stop there.
It's so, just going to progress into superhumans, all this stuff.
Right.
Yeah, oh boy.
Jared, what's up? Okay, so here's the direction, dude. Here's all where right. I wanted to go with this. Yes, and by the way, this is true. Go listen to that podcast with Joe Rogan and Elon Musk. So Joe Rogan, he's sitting there like totally mind blown. Like, what the fuck, dude?
Yeah.
Like, are you kidding me? He's like, well, it doesn't stop there, right? And Elon's like, no. He's like, it's just going to get more and more and more. And he's like, well, what do you mean? And Elon's like, well, you know that soon we will be totally integrated with AI, meaning it'll be a part of who we are, all of us. And we will have no other option but for it to happen. And Joe's like, I don't know about you guys, but that's scary to me.
It is scary because we will be controlled.
We will be controlled. Yeah. And he's like, and then Elon's response was, well, let me ask you something. He said, your phones right now, are they a part of you?
More than your wallet.
Yeah, it is. It's an extension of us.
It is an extension, right?
Yeah,
it is. And that is exactly what he said. He said, your phones right now are an extension of you. Mm-hmm. Like, so you are technically, at this point, I think he called a symbiote or whatever.
It's true, because it does take control of us. It's basically kind of like a journalized version of us, but we're putting it out in the world.
But we have to have our phones. So this is an extension of us, right? So information... Like, if we want to know anything, what is the first thing we do?
We
go to Google,
yeah.
Right? So it's just like, okay, well, I've got to figure out this. If I want to know data on the coronavirus or I want to know data about anything, what do? I go to Google and I'm like, okay, well, where's studies on this, and this, right? Mm-hmm. So basically, this is an information extension of us currently. Mm-hmm. If we didn't have this, guess what? We are now... pretty much less.
Right? Do you remember Encyclopedia Britannica?
Yeah. The encyclopedia.
Oh, my God.
Damon said, what the hell, my golf game?
Okay. So Joe Rogan, he said, well, that's scary to me, man, because if we're... He said, okay, let's back up. Elon said, the problem is that information processing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We can only process so much. Our brains can only process so much information so fast.
Mm-hmm.
But he said the reason why we are trying to develop these things, these AI for humans, is so that information goes and transfers at a faster pace. So what happens is, like instantly, instead of us going to our phones to Google, our minds will interact with artificial intelligence, and we will know.
I get it, bro, but...
Well, okay. But here's the thing. Once this starts...
It ain't stopping.
You don't stop it. You don't stop it. So what... I'm just saying. It's crazy talk, right? It's crazy talk, but it's reality. Because according to Elon, they're in development, and this is the direction that they are going. Like, they are going here. You know what he said? This is crazy. Are you ready for this?
Yeah.
This will blow all your minds. If you didn't listen to this podcast, Elon said within 5 years, he thinks that all speaking communication will halt. Because we will develop technology that, again, goes directly, connects to humans to where communication is super basic. He said that it'll be computer and brain to computer and brain without actually speaking.
Yeah.
I could see that working.
I'm just saying. Listen, I'm just the relayer.
No, I get it. Okay, so how do you feel about it?
I don't like it.
I don't either.
I don't like it. No. I'm just saying. I'm just talking about this is it, where it, we are okay. going.
But then we could be like pre-programmed to. There's no challenge. We're, you know what I mean? We're right. going in uncharted waters.
Yeah,
we're going in a section of like we're pretending to be the guy upstairs, and you know what I mean.
Listen, I am 100% agreeing with you here.
Ain't nobody putting nothing in my head.
I'm just telling you that, like that this is where we are going. Like this is the direction that we are heading. And okay. Artificial intelligence just in general, right? I mean, we think about...
And, you know, like you mentioned, and I don't mean to cut you off, but you mentioned the fact that, okay, it's going to get people who can't see to see. Okay, people who can't walk now will be able to walk.
That's cool.
That is super cool. Right. The problem is, once they get that working, it's like, oh...
So, I don't want to lie to y'all, but yeah. whenever you first mentioned it, you know what I first thought of? The whole scene in Dr. Octavius and Spider-Man 2 where everything went crazy and
it
kind of like overwhelmed the whole entire... I don't mean to be like funny about it, but I mean, it's kind of that same scenario that it just kind of
scares. It is.
So, my here's my thing. If you start developing artificial intelligence to the point to where it can start thinking for itself, because... All you have to do is give it that freedom. You know that, right? Because right now, artificial intelligence is controlled. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Right? We can totally...
Right now.
We have... Yes.
Right
it's,
now
it's
it
controlled.
Is.
Yeah. What... The moment that... And this is like Terminator shit, right? This is so Terminator shit. What happens when we give permission for an artificial intelligence to think on its own?
Yeah.
Because once you have a computer that's able to think, it will be mind-boggling where it goes.
Okay.
To where it'll be totally out of control.
So I was just about to say what Tim Wolf said. What about when the hackers could get into you?
That's the next question.
Boom.
Right? That's the next thing. Yeah. Because you know...
I'm with you, Derek. Next beer.
Right. Yeah, you want to grab the... somebody. So okay. You know that... what were we just talking about?
I think this beer is making us philosophers right now.
We're going like, damn, bro, I don't think we need to be drinking bourbon beer.
It's fun. I don't know.
No.
I'm just saying, like, this is a topic that was so interesting. It was fascinating to me.
It is fascinating. It's just, you know that, like, you're at the ledge. Do I take the next step or what? You know what I mean? Not a boy.
The bourbon barrel, yeah. So it's a little scary, right? I mean, it's a little scary, but here that
George said you have to rip the processor out the back of your neck,
right? I mean, it's almost like Matrix Terminator shit, but
no,
it's
dude,
almost
it's all this. Like, what was that Will Smith movie?
After Earth?
No. Where all these like artificial intelligence robots and all this.
Oh, iRobot.
iRobot,
right,
dude.
But here's the thing, you're right. If you okay,
oh, this one feels good.
So if you would do that, right?
Uh-huh.
In order for you to communicate with the chip in your head, okay, let's say it's at the basic form where it helps with disabilities.
Salud.
Okay, so it helps with disabilities, right? So in order for it to communicate with an outside device, it would have to be Bluetooth, right? What is, you guys, and this is my thoughts exactly, and Joe Rogan brought this up too. He said, well, what if someone smart enough hacks into your damn brain?
Yeah.
Like, what are you going to do? Oh, you want to hear the scariest part about this? Here's the scariest part. Elon said that it will get to the point where you can manipulate memories.
No. And that's what I'm talking about. It starts getting into...
Right? That scared the shit out of me.
Yeah.
That scared the hell out of me. Because if you get to the point to where you can now manipulate your own memories and create your own memories, then total reality is lost, right?
But I would think something like that would there would be some type of law passed because that allows our inability to think freely on anything.
I don't know. I'm just saying. But he said that's what he talked about. He said, yes, it can and probably will get to the point to where you can manipulate specific memories. So, and the whole time, all I'm thinking about is, okay, what happens if our government or somebody who in power wants to control people to where they totally hack in?
No, they don't have to do that. They just throw out a virus, and then they manipulate everything you do.
They control everything. Like, yeah. you are literally
You don't even have to put a chip in me yet.
But you're right. You guys are so right. This is a direction that is so scary.
It is.
But Elon said, guys, this is reality. Mm-hmm. Like, this is what we are moving to.
Whew. So, all right.
Let's talk about the next one.
Next beer.
Let me talk about this. This is my favorite.
All right, bro. Go ahead. I don't want to take your show, bro. Go ahead. No, hurry up.
It's not my show. It's our show.
Yeah, it is our show.
It is. This is my beer.
Okay.
Okay, because...
That's your baby.
This is a sentiment to me.
Okay.
So my first ever... It is.
Did you hear that? There you go. All right.
My first ever bourbon beer was this one up in Ohio. And it means a lot to me because on date night, Melinda and I, this is what we used to drink together.
Oh, yeah?
So we like our first date nights ever being together, we would go out and we'd get the bourbon barrel ale up in Ohio because somebody recommended it. And what the hell? Let me mute that. So, yeah. This stuff, and I don't know if you knew this, by the way.
Probably not, because I haven't drank it.
This beer is aged in old Woodford Reserve.
Yeah, okay. That I did know.
Yeah, I told you that. This is my favorite, although that one was really good too. But this is my favorite bourbon barrel.
That was real good.
It's strong, because I'm feeling
like,
good.
Hey.
Yep. All right.
I'm entering the faith zone.
Yeah.
All right, bro.
George Hay said Mexicans don't have to worry about it because we don't pay for Wi-Fi.
We don't. We hack the neighbors.
Damn. 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 Woo.
That's my comps.
Damien said, I just got a new 9mm Freedom Ordnance FX9 with 1,000 rounds. Stock up, fellas. Hell yeah. Dude, where did you find 9mm ammo? Do you have a gun? You have 9mm?
Yep.
Have you been able to find ammo anywhere?
Haven't had to go look anywhere.
Dude, I cannot. Well, I don't. I have enough now. But I've been going out. It is gone.
It doesn't even exist.
So, no, it is non-existent at this point.
9mm, and then
45.
And the ones they use on the AR-15.
The 5.56.
Yeah.
You cannot find.
Nope.
Or 223.
Didn't you say last time you went to Cabela's and they had something?
Dude, but it was a rare thing, dude. As soon as I walked in, they had put the pallet out of the 5.56 ammo, and I bought two massive cases of it.
Damn.
Yeah. Yeah. But, man.
Can we drink this now? Like, I'm
hungry. Hey, cheers. Let's go.
Cheers, bro.
Yeah, you could. We're talking about guns now. Damien's running off guns. I'm going to talk about guns.
Let me see. Aroma. Very similar to the other one.
Smoother. Oh.
There's a little bit of smoke to it.
Huh?
There's a little bit of a smoke.
Yeah.
Okay. I get it. It's like when the abuelita burned the cinnamon for the flan.
A little bit.
Not the cinnamon, the sugar. There you go.
Damien said, what's funny is that it was also my first bourbon barrel ale, the Kentucky bourbon barrel ale.
That's a little sweeter than what I'm used to, but it's good.
It's really good, right? What is the percentage on this? I don't even know.
This one, prepare yourself, guys. It is,
Doesn't say.
I don't see it.
Let me look it up. I'm kind of curious.
Here's my extension.
Go to the extension of yourself, please.
But for real, it's an extension of me. My freaking phone. All right.
Very fun fact. I've seen people trade ammo for all kinds of things during COVID. Yes.
8%.
8%.
This is 8 plus percent.
I'm looking.
Are we being bejeejees?
No, we're not.
I think the first one started off pretty well. So.
8.1.
8.1.
Yeah.
Okay, so
the other one's stronger.
And I'm not even going on the stronger. I think I like the flavor of the first one first. wait a minute, the first one better.
You like the first one better.
This tastes a lot more like regular beer to me. Just very stout.
It's definitely lighter. Yeah. I mean, you can tell the difference. Well, that's 12%. This is 8%.
Yeah.
You can tell the difference.
The other one felt a little bit more like syrupy, a little bit thicker.
Yeah.
It was definitely thicker. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
That's what she said.
Yeah. That is what she said. Woo! Damien said that Bass Pro headquarters in Springfield. It's a lot of ammo.
Lots of ammo.
Man.
That's not bad of a drive.
We might have to, man.
Stop and pick up. We'll pick up ammo and whiskeys on the way back home.
I got so much ammo right now that I could literally last for probably 2 years shooting every day at zombies. But I always need more, right? It's good, though, right?
It's really good.
Yeah.
It's really good. I kind of like the bourbon barrel quad a little bit better.
That hurts my heart.
I love you, bro.
Do we need a group hug? No.
Do we need a group hug?
You know what I had to say?
What? That you like the first one better, too.
I do.
I know.
Listen, I do. That has more flavor to it.
It does.
Sucks, man. Cause
it's okay. I get it.
This hurts me, dude.
I know.
Right here, this is a big thing.
And like, you know what?
My boobs hurt from lifting right now. Jesus.
Listen.
Yeah.
Your flavor profile is so close to mine.
I know.
That we're always.
I know.
And I know you guys think we BS, okay?
We don't BS. There's
we don't. No BS, we really don't. Guys. And we have proof now. So for all of you that think we're always in tune, oh, we got to say that. No. We're live. We both tried at the same time. We both agree. And we have a witness.
Yeah.
Can you get on camera? They might not believe me. I'm just saying. Because a lot of people call us on our crap, say that
it's so good, man.
I'm the witness.
He's a witness.
Yep.
It's so good, that bourbon
next
barrel
time we're gonna
quad.
Wear full hats on the next show.
Yeah,
damn,
it is. That one's better. This is still good.
This one you can taste a lot of the barley on.
You can
you could taste this of a regular beer.
Exactly,
right?
Which is scary.
Yeah,
it is scary
because
it's
8%
lighter, but you don't expect it because
right.
Yep.
And we had that one like it wasn't even chilled, bro.
It wasn't chilled. It was warm.
It was warmer.
Well, because I was buying a truck. I was buying a truck, and I couldn't buy.
No. We're not making excuses. But could you imagine what this tastes ice cold?
Oh, I can't wait.
Yeah, I think we need to have some over the weekend.
Yeah.
So.
Oh darn! What the taste?
Oh shucks.
Damn.
Yeah, we're going to have to be drinking some beer this weekend. Damn you, Josh.
Did you get your gun yet? You talked about it.
I'm looking. I'm still, I think, 226. 6-0. The SIG.
226?
Yeah, 226. From SIG. I can't do a compact. No, bro. It's a 9mm, but it's the P226 from SIG.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. I'm like, wait a minute.
Like, I really like that, what do you have? The,
I have the XD. Springfield.
Springfield.
Yeah, XD, the 9mm.
It's just look, bro. And I'm not, look.
Yeah, what?
And then look at your hand.
It's small.
Yeah, bro. So like, the one that you have is perfect for you. I'm a bigger guy, bro, so I could carry something a little bit bigger.
You do not want to carry a 45.
I'm not carrying a 45. It's a 9mm, bro.
Why not? What?
The Springfield is
size.
No, bro. The freaking thing ends right here on me, bro. Come on, man.
I don't know. Listen, you're not going to want to carry that.
It's
the smaller,
honestly,
the better.
I know. But honestly,
you understand that?
The Springfield that you showed me the other day compared to the 226 from 226 from SIG is maybe that much of a difference.
Yeah, I mean, listen, the smaller the gun.
Yes, sir. Go Raiders.
What, the Las Vegas Raiders now?
Yeah, whatever, bro. We're freaking Raiders. Hold on. It's the Raiders.
Is that how it is?
That's it. That's the Al Davis. The Raiders.
I didn't know that that's how you say it.
It is.
I'll have to get on that path. The red ass. The red ass. You sound like a zombie.
It is, bro. Did you ever see Al Davis, bro? That dude was like, you know, bless his heart. He's up in heaven or wherever the heck he is, but I'm glad he croaked because the Raiders finally got better. Wait. And you know what? For all you Cowgirl fans, until Mr. Lover of the Blue Label, Jerry Jones, doesn't croak, you guys ain't doing nothing. I said it. Oh, well.
Don't offend me.
Huh?
You don't offend me.
I don't offend you? No. All right, bro.
You're not a Cowboys fan?
No.
What's your team?
I don't have a preference, but Cowboys are... If I did, Cowboys weren't in that option at all.
That's
all
you know what, though?
I ain't watching NFL this year anyways.
This is a Dallas Stars fan. I do know that. He's a big hockey fan. So, right there, bro. Look.
Dude, six is a night.
Oh, shit.
What is the score? We got to find this out. This is big.
What's the series?
This is...
Is it 3-2? Who?
This is a big deal.
Don't remind me.
Hold on.
They're not going to get eliminated, right, bro?
I don't know. We got to find out.
3-2 against the Flames.
NHL, there we go. 9:30. They play at 9:30.
Yep.
Okay.
The Flames. They play against the Flames.
Wait, okay, but no, but Dallas. No. I'm a LA Kings, bro.
That's right. I'm sorry.
George Hay said they signed Amari Cooper for $100 million. I don't even care, man.
They sure did, bro. They could have him.
I'm over the NFL, man.
Huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I am.
I know. Bro, I get it.
You know me.
I know, bro.
I'm over the NFL.
I have not. I'm going to say it.
Okay.
On live TV.
Okay.
I have not watched my Lakers. No. I have not.
Okay.
It's too much for me to handle.
It's too much.
That's it. I'm going to leave it there.
It's too much.
You've never had a Kentucky bourbon ale.
You know what?
It is good.
We watch Los Doyos.
Hell yeah, we'll
watch Los Indios. Indios.
Yeah. So,
you know what?
Los Doyos,
I don't know.
Los Indios.
You said that you were going to make me Los Indios shirt.
I know, bro. It's just, you guys have some funky font. That's not the easiest thing to
do. What do you mean?
Yeah, bro. Listen. You know me, that anything I do, it has to be, like, legit. If not, then I won't even attempt it.
Right. Well, I just want a Los Indios shirt.
I know. And so I'll wear my... Oh, put some freaking pressure on me, bro, next week, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Because I leave the next week. Or no, I don't. My parents are here.
Yeah.
So I don't leave the next week.
You don't. Okay, so
next
we got 2 weeks.
All right,
then
we got
2 weeks. Okay, episode... 26. Los Doyers,
and Los Indios.
All right, we'll figure it out. No Amber Alert. All right,
there is an Amber Alert.
Well, there was one, yeah. But I went poof, be gone.
Amari Cooper.
Freaking they could have him for $100 million.
Cowboys.
Those cowgirls.
It's too early for this. Drunk. 11% beer gets me every time, dude. You're telling us.
Yeah.
I'm feeling glorious.
Right here, 12.2. Right. Damn.
It's good. I mean, it's good, but damn.
And I was going to bring one, too.
Oh, you're going to bring one.
That was going to be like 12.9.
Damn. What is it?
It's one that I found in Colorado.
Was it good?
I haven't tasted it yet.
Oh, you were in Colorado when I was in Colorado. Mm-hmm.
I was over there from the... ninth to the 14th.
Oh, you were?
Mm-hmm. But I was in SS Park. I was in a completely different area than you.
I was in Taylor Park, man. That place is... What?
Back to the beer.
Okay, we're back to the Kentucky Bourbon Barrel Ale.
So we had the Boulevard,
yeah,
right?
The Boulevard Bourbon Barrel...
Which was...
Quad.
Yes, which was barely starting into the chill mode. I don't think I could have this in the same temperature as we had that.
Really?
Yeah, bro. It's
that was really good.
It was freaking awesome, bro.
God, 12% though is strong. One of those got us strong.
But it's okay because you know what? We could have two of these on a hot day and we'll be all right.
Yeah,
that was the guy right there.
Matt, dude,
black
Matt.
Back in Blackberry.
Hey, Matt's going in a direction I don't want to go.
Uh-oh, what'd he say?
He's talking about the Big Ten.
Oh, it's over. It's done. There ain't no college football. Okay, we're over. Cheers, bro.
I don't want to cheers to that. Why? That is not a good thing.
Bro, I know it's not a good thing.
Do you understand?
No.
You know what? You do your shit. Talk.
Okay,
talk.
I'm going to talk.
What? What? Go.
There's no way that you're going to keep that type of fan base out of the stadiums.
No.
College football is about that fan
base.
Dude,
it's Ohio State. We have the number one fan base in the country.
I understand that. And you think you think they're not going to want to be at the game?
I want to be at the game. I will pay $1,000 to go sit at the game this year.
Who's better at karaoke, Carlos or Josh? Probably. Well, it depends. Are we going to be singing some Spanish music? Then I totally got my boy.
What?
Yeah, what? I gotta get the field even,
what?
Bro.
Why would we be singing Spanish music?
I think Josh has a better voice. Mine's a little,
I don't know,
a little raspy. I don't know. Whatever. But yeah.
Okay, so let's go back to the Big Ten. All right.
Okay.
What is going on, dude? What is going on? Why are they doing this?
It is going back to what we just talked about.
Bullshit?
Talked about
straight bullshit?
Yes. We talked about AI. We talked about the government controlling us and doing all this BS, and that's where we're at.
So the Big Ten, and here's the problem, man. Ohio State arguably has one of the best teams that they've ever had in the history of the program.
And guess what?
And we're not going to play.
No, you're not.
Because our stupid Big Ten commissioner or whatever he is,
they should have done interconference at least, and you know you guys would have took that like there's no tomorrow, and then pick the winner from each conference and then do a small playoff and then boom.
Agreed.
But it ain't gonna.
How in the world? Okay, of all the conferences, it's so ironic to me that the ACC and the SEC are still going and the Big 12 are still going, right?
Jeff Mishler is. He's a Oregon fan. I'm a.
Well, the Pac-12, Trojan. The Pac-12 dropped out too, didn't they?
Yeah, they. I think they did.
They did.
Yeah,
but
so.
Okay, let's address this because this is a sour subject for me. The Big Ten.
This is getting a little sour for me, bro.
This is the stop being a little vajiji.
I'm just saying, bro.
Just drink your damn bourbon barrel ale.
I'm drinking a damn thing. I'm just I gotta let people know. Drink this ice cold.
No, it.
Yeah.
It's good ice cold. But you have the Big Ten, okay? What is Melinda doing? Oh, she's watering the plants. You have the Big Ten, which is in the northern states.
Uh-huh.
Right? The Big Ten in the northern states where the virus is gone. Hmm. It's gone, dude. Like, if you look at the statistics, the virus is gone.
But everybody has to tackle on, because then what is it going to be? A Big Ten championship?
No, I'm just saying. The point is that why are you canceling a season when the virus is basically non-existent at this point in the northern states?
I understand that.
But the SEC in the southern states, which is coming off of its peak and actually like 4 weeks off its peak, still has a season. What the hell is going on here?
So does that mean the Big Ten is a bunch of pansies?
You know what?
I'm not insulting anybody. I'm just saying.
I can't disagree with you.
Okay. Cheers.
No, I can't disagree with you here.
I'm just saying.
No, the Big Ten commissioner is a pansy. I don't even know who that is. I don't even know who the Big Ten commissioner is. Who makes these decisions?
Some guy that...
That has no idea what he's talking about! He doesn't look at the statistics!
Maybe he's a...
Oh, for sure, dude. No. For sure. 100,000,000%.
Oh, yeah.
They have no idea what we're saying.
No.
But we're going to keep it at that.
And I can't say it. I want to. I'm dying to, but I'm not.
But seriously, man. I mean, these kids. This is their life. You saw Justin Fields came out, right? Is it blinking?
I'm just checking on the battery.
Oh.
Is it blinking?
No, it's good.
No, it's not blinking.
Good.
Okay.
We almost made a 2-hour show.
I remember that. That's what I'm checking.
Justin Fields came out and created a petition for the Big Ten. There's like 300,000 signatures, dude. 300,000 signatures that to keep. What is going on? How in the world? These are kids that live. What? Oh, I know. These are kids that want to play sports, dude.
I understand.
This is their life.
Well, it is.
For a lot of them, it is.
Because
they're trying to move to the NFL. This is their ticket to the NFL. Their ticket.
Yeah.
And you're limiting these kids and what they could do. And not only that, now you're hurting these schools. You're not only hurting the players, you're hurting the schools, because I don't want to go to Ohio State now.
Well,
what? They're gonna have their own season in the spring with just Big Ten teams? You know what I'm saying?
What if they're going for the edumacation?
Okay. Really?
Woo! The commissioner is what?
We're not going to say that.
We are not.
We're not going to say that.
They are not going to sucker me into that.
Nope, not on here. With all this audio surrounding us.
Off the record, we'll say it proudly.
Yeah.
Yeah, but Derek Kurtz, no secrets, huh?
Well, it's too bad.
Listen, you guys been watching us long enough to know what we probably said. And if you don't,
if you don't know, you're not going to know. Ninja!
Ninja!
Oh, man. I don't know. I just want people to get back to normal. I want everything to get back to normal like it should. But
this is the worst thing. We are like the greatest nation in the world. And we are so far behind everybody else. Like, all these other places are like,
no.
Done.
Hold on.
It's true.
Hold on.
Okay.
You say that. We are not that far behind them.
Our thought process.
Okay. I will give you that.
That's what I'm referring to.
Statistically, data-wise, we are not behind them.
No. But our thought process of how we do things.
Political.
Yeah. But it's
that. That is where we are.
Yeah. It's like, come on now. We are letting. Man, I didn't want to get there, but we're letting.
Go there.
We are letting two political parties dictate how we are living our lives.
Both of them.
It's so one-sided that I think the political parties is what's creating this separation in our nation. It's not us. It's not Americans. It's the political parties. It's what. Yeah. Damn.
You're right, dude. You're right, man.
And that's what's so.
If you can take
effed up about this whole situation,
you could take that aspect out. It would not be where it is today.
No,
with everything, and I think everybody wants normalcy. We all want. We want to watch freaking college. I want to watch college football.
Bro, I want to go to Home Depot and I have to put a freaking mask on my face. I want to go to work and I have to worry about putting a mask on my face.
Well,
like,
I don't wear a mask anywhere. So,
you know, it's whatever. Yeah, we're not gonna go there.
Yeah, well, we did.
By the way, bro. Finish this beer because it's getting a little
warm.
Yeah, it's a little sour on it.
I know, but it's strong.
Are you being a Vajiji?
No, there's no Vajiji.
I'm just saying.
Matt said the virus is either going to go away or get worse November 4th.
Literally.
So true, man.
And that's it. It's like, you know, that's so sad. I've never been so excited for November 4th like I am right now. Seriously.
For real.
I mean,
just get it over with, for God's sake.
It's so funny because it's going to be November 4th. Boom, 1 week. Boom. Okay, it's over.
Everything's done.
Everything. Take the mask. All that is gone.
All that.
Yeah.
Done. Everything's
just
done.
Just miraculously.
Boom.
All the cases go away. Everything goes away.
I know, man. I know.
Damn.
Whatever. You know what?
Cheers, bro. Cheers.
Cheers.
Man, thank you for being here.
He's like, oh shit, what did I get into?
Yeah, what'd you get yourself into?
He's like, the first time
at all. I'm just watching the whole thing going down right now.
He's like, the first time that they get political. Here
yeah,
we go.
We damn
here we go.
Work.
Golly.
Guys, if I go missing.
If I go missing. Hey, why do you think I keep going on these trips? Mm-hmm. I keep going on these trips out the middle of Colorado where I have no signal, no service, because I'm escaping this.
It's just a bunch of nonsense.
It's nonsense, man.
God, bro.
Over in Colorado, they're so open about it. They don't... Not many people are really...
No.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
They just don't care over there. Mm-mm. What? Bro, what are you talking... All right, let's talk about Kentucky Bourbon Barrel.
Because I knew that this was like your thing, bro.
Don't hurt my feelings.
I'm not trying to hurt your feelings, bro, but
I know you're going there. Just stab me in the heart right now. Just do it.
Just get it over with. Like, kill shot.
Mm-hmm.
I was expecting this one. Because, like, we saved this one to the end.
The problem is that we saved it to the end.
We should have had it first, huh?
Should have had it first because...
Well... In your defense, you'd never tasted this one.
I've never tasted that one.
No. Yeah, so.
I should have brought that.
Yeah, so, guys, look. As much as it's going to hurt my boys' feelings, these are the two bourbon barrel beers that we had. The one on the left is the one you need to go buy.
Hillary said.
If they don't have this one, you could settle for this one.
Okay. Just remember, for each bourbon barrel beer, it's a one-hour show.
It is.
So
it's almost, an hour and a half.
Yeah, whatever.
Just saying.
Hillary said that California's Central Valley is up in smoke. Looks like fog 40 miles
it
away.
It is.
That's awful.
Oh, it is. We have actually a close friend. We have a close friend that are a hop and a skip from having to evacuate. It's sad, bro. It is really sad.
Could
you imagine, though? It's like us, you know, we build these homes, we put our heart into them, and then have to say, I gotta run from this.
Hell no.
But, I mean, that's the reality. That's what those people are looking at. They're looking at the fire like, is it going to happen? It's not. And they start gathering up their stuff. Like, one of Veronica's ex-boss, who's a great friend of hers, that's what they're in. They're in that situation right now. And it sucks.
This is happening every year, I'm serious. It's happening every year now, right?
And that happened in Colorado this year.
Yes, it did.
Over
because
around Beaver Creek.
We couldn't do a fire.
Yeah.
The first time we went out, we were not allowed to build a fire. Now we are. Now we did last week, but we weren't allowed because of that.
Right.
Damn, this is getting very...
It just sucks, man. What?
We're all hyped up, and we're gonna mill it out.
Yeah, what the?
Well, we're drunk. I mean, I'm drunk. At least I'm drunk.
Well, I'm feeling it. Yeah.
Climate change. No, geez. Here we go.
Yeah, we don't want to get into that. We already got. But I pray not another paradise.
But it really seems like that this is happening every year. I mean, I know the last year it happened.
Well,
if
you look at, okay, so. You probably don't know, but so Veronica and I up Northern Cal, we had a property, and when we purchased this property, this was going to be like the retirement thing.
Yeah.
Creeks and rivers up in Red Bluff, and it got to the point where the stream, everything was drying up, bro. It's not enough water, so much dry vegetation that anything sparks it in. And it just goes. But
yeah, that's what she said.
Really? Not dry though.
Ooh, never dry.
Never dry. That's painful.
Hold on, I gotta play something for you.
What are you gonna play for me?
Yes.
Alright. We should talk about football again. Yeah! Hey, how about we talk about Los Dodgers?
Los Dodgers!
Indios!
Hold on.
Play Tennessee Whiskey. Did you hear that?
There it is.
That's what I'm talking about!
It's our jam.
Man, I wish we could bump that damn thing.
Should we finish up with a little whiskey?
Yes, sir.
We should.
No more beer.
No more beer. Let me chug this, and we're going to finish this episode with some...
Used to spend my nights at the bar.
Uh-oh. Whoa!
Oh, snap! The ninja. Ninja, can you come on camera?
Come on, ninja.
Come on, ninja.
Come on, ninja.
Even though you're not the ninja tonight, you are my ninja.
But you rescued me from reaching for the bottom.
Just say hi.
Right there. Say hi.
No.
Oh, damn!
No! Not this is yet. Not this yet.
Oh, it's me. Tasting whiskey.
But you know what, bro?
You're a sweet.
Okay, let it out. We need to up the beat. So you know which one should come on?
What?
I think we need my upbeat song.
Honk tonk.
Down
to the honky tonk.
We need to like, boom boom. You know? Can you play Down to the Honky Tonk?
Don't you? Is that what you want
like,
me to play?
Like, for reals, bro.
I got you.
I got
kitties. No, I got you. I got you, bro.
This is the one that some people could have said that it improved me. Some people would have said it corrupted me. But this is what got me into country music. Look at that.
This is your jam.
That's my cut right there. And we're gonna sing this whole damn song, bro.
Sing it. Well, like a couple, like a minute.
Got a house, got a back road, got a flag. On the front porch, you got a dog named Waylon. Got a driveway that he's paving. Got a boat with a two-stroke, a couple guaranteed to make you laugh jokes. Got friends in low places. Yeah, life is what you make it. I might not end up in the Hall of Fame with a star on the sidewalk with my name. With a statue in my hometown when I'm gone. Nobody gonna name their babies after me. I might not go down in history, but I'll go down to the honky tonk. Named Sheila, she's going mad shit. On tequila, I got a job that gets the job done. I got a loan at the bank, it's a big one.
Alright, we gotta stop. Alright, let's talk. Good time call, well, damn, and a local legend on a Friday night with a Pabst Blue Ribbon neon light. I might not end up in the Hall of Fame with a star on the sidewalk with my name or a statue in my hometown when I'm gone.
All right.
Yes, sir.
See that, bro. You got freaking singing on the
he
spot.
He got karaoke on
you
the spot.
You got karaoke.
I got politics. I got AI. I got...
You got everything.
We went all over the place.
No, we didn't go hard into politics.
No.
You whispered politics to me.
I did.
You whispered politics.
I did.
We didn't go hard into politics. No, we just talked a little bit about the virus and how it's not existing anymore. But well, you know what? You know what? Social distancing, 6 feet with a mask. Where's your mask here, buddy?
Huh?
What mask?
Didn't have any.
You don't see it?
He has a mask on.
I do.
Chris does. And you do.
Yeah. And you do too.
Yeah.
Give
the boys another drink. Oh, we lost a lot of people
from singing,
dude. We lost like nine people.
I thought it was gonna get better.
You know what?
All right. So what are we gonna finish this off this night off with?
Water probably is a good idea. I'm just saying.
No, we need a whiskey.
All right.
Which I want.
Let's whiskey it up after we end the show, because we're losing people. It's time to go.
It is, huh?
Yeah.
What time is it?
It's way past our bedtime.
Like
an hour and 40 minutes. Well, guys, I think it's time.
It's a good show.
It was a good show.
Thank you guys for tuning in to Whiskey Winning episode number 24.
Yes, thanks for Chris for joining us.
Chris joined us today.
Yep. Screwball shots. Oh, hell
no.
No.
We do have that, though.
No, I ain't doing that crap.
I'm not doing that either.
No.
All right.
They can't even, like, no. They can't even triple dare us to that. No.
Not going there.
No. Nope.
All right. Hey, You know what, guys? Thank you for tuning in. Episode number 24. We are done. We're going to wrap it up, and we're going to drink some more whiskey.
Yeah, I'm going to drink some water, though.
Water and whiskey.
Yeah. Deuces.
Deuces. All right. Holy balls.